Now, after you've had ancestry testing, or any sort of genome-wide genetic testing, you can learn some interesting information about yourself. It turns out that not all of those individual differences that are genetic mutations, SNPs, that distinguish human populations are neutral. That is, they only tell us about our ancestry. They don't do anything to us personally. Some mutations, in other words, actually cause genetic disorders or diseases. And some of those genetic mutations that distinguish people are also related to genetic diseases. So one common example is Tay-Sachs, which is a common mutation in a gene that's related specifically, normally, to the Ashkenazi Jewish population. So that's a case where there's a mutation that's both common only to one group of people, or almost only one group of people, and relates specifically to a human disease. So I want to tell you briefly about one medically relevant mutation in humans that's also used in ancestry testing. And that is the case of lactose intolerance, the ability to digest milk products. And in most humans, in the adults, we lose our ability, the common thing is to lose the ability to digest milk and milk products. It's common for babies because, of course, we're all meant to drink milk and milk only as infants. But then as we age, we're normally going to lose the ability to tolerate milk. But there are some parts of the world, in the Western Sahara, in Scandinavia and the British Isles, and also in Saudi Arabia, that there are small groups of people that evolved the ability to keep digesting milk products in adulthood. And so those three groups all have mutations in or near a gene. This is a screenshot up here from the Human Genome Browser, a website you can go to look at the human genome sequence. In one of these populations, there's a mutation called, and you can't read it from there, it's called RS182549. It's just a code that geneticists give to one single nucleotide polymorphism, one SNP mutation, and it's nearby, but not in, the gene that encodes lactase. So here, on this part of this chromosome, chromosome 2 in humans, is the gene called lactase. It's a gene that encodes a protein, an enzyme, that is the enzyme that breaks down milk sugars, that lets us digest milk products. So that gene is normally turned on in infants so they can digest lactose, and then in most humans, it turns off later in life, and that leads to lactose intolerance. And it turns out this single nucleotide polymorphism has two forms. You can either have a C at this specific spot in your genome, and that's the common or typical form that leads to lactose intolerance. If you have a T instead of a C at this one spot, on this one chromosome, that's associated with, not necessarily always causes, but normally causes lactose tolerance. And that mutation is over here in a different gene, the gene that's next to lactase. There's a second gene next here on chromosome 2, right next to it. And this mutation is inside this gene, but its effect is on whether or not that lactase protein gets produced into adulthood. That's really interesting. And scientists understand the basics of why that is, and I won't explain it to you now, but maybe in a future video. So the T form exists mostly in Western Europe. But when scientists looked at the genetics of people from Western Africa and in Saudi Arabia, they didn't necessarily see that T. This raises a really important point, which is that different mutations, like the T at RS182549, can cause lactase to be expressed, the protein produced, into adulthood. But that mutation is not the only mutation in all of our chromosomes that could lead to the same result, production of lactase in adulthood. So presumably, these other two populations of humans have different mutations somewhere else in their genomes that still let them have the same trait, the trait of lactase production in adulthood. And so I want to give reference or give a credit to these three, four groups, that these are their citations to the primary literature, the publications. The first publication is the identification of lactase, the C and the T types, as being related to lactase persistence, the ability to digest into adulthood. The Ingram et al. Article is the one that showed that there was the T mutation associated with lactose tolerance, particularly in Northern Europe, Scandinavia, and the British Isles. And the third reference here, Gabal et al., is the one that showed the persistence of lactase in these three separate groups, but not looking necessarily at the genetics. Tishkoff et al., this is the last reference down here, did actually show that in one African population, there actually was a totally different mutation in that group that does cause lactase persistence in adulthood, proving that point that I made a minute or two ago, that different mutations in different parts of the genome can still make the same effect, the same trait, the production of lactase into adulthood. So the reason that genetic testing isn't great at predicting disease is because of that fact, that different mutations can produce the same trait. So just because you get your genome sequenced or genetic testing, if you found out your genotype at RS182549 and it said you were C, typical, that is, you were probably lactose intolerant, that doesn't mean you are lactose intolerant, because there might be some other mutation somewhere else in the genome that causes lactase expression in adulthood and allows you to be lactose tolerant. So that's another point about genetic testing. Just because you get genetically tested doesn't mean you're going to get a particular disease. Because most human diseases rely on the impact and the effects of multiple genes, sometimes spread across multiple chromosomes. So if you just look at one site on one chromosome, you can say maybe this is 90% predictive, but there are very, very few human medical diseases and disorders where a single gene causes the entire trait. The last point to make about genetic testing and medical testing is that, not related to genetics, there's a huge impact of environment on your phenotype, on disease risk. So genetics is not everything. It's both nature and nurture. It has something to do with your genotypes and your DNA sequences, but then there's a large component that has to do with what you eat, what air you breathe, and so forth. So related to lactase persistence then, as a test of how accurate some genetic testing companies are, a few years ago I had my DNA tested by two different companies just to compare which one was better than the other, and I'm not going to tell you which companies I used, but I just wanted to show you an example of the results that I got. So the first thing that I saw when these companies sent my testing back to me was the world map shaded in with colors and your probability that, not surprisingly for me, I'm mostly Scandinavian with some British Isles ancestry and maybe a little bit of otherwise continental Europe, France, Germany, maybe a little Italian. So nobody was shocked by looking at me, and I already knew that my ancestry was mostly British and Scandinavian. But what was even more interesting to me was when I started digging into the data you can download from these companies after you get your genetic testing. You can actually get from them for free, you can download it usually from your user account, a spreadsheet or a text file that has all of the different SNPs that they looked at and will tell you what letters were in your genome at each spot that they looked at. So it's not just the already interpreted for you color-coded map. You can get your genetic information. And so here, this is a screenshot from the Excel file, the spreadsheet. And so at this row, 91,000, the 91,000 somethingth SNP that they looked at was RS182549, the one that predicts, to a certain extent, lactose tolerance. And I will never give up eating cheese. I am totally lactose tolerant and I love cheese and ice cream. So I knew that I was lactase persistent, lactose tolerant. And I have the TT type. So what that means is on both of my chromosomes, there's a T at that spot. And remember from the previous segment that the T is associated with lactase persistence, the ability to digest lactose into adulthood. And so at this chromosome, on chromosome 2, at about, oh my goodness, 136 million base pairs from nucleotide 1, 136 million base pairs in at that chromosome, this position, I have a T on both of my chromosomes. That's what the genetic testing company did for me. But not just at this one nucleotide. They did it so many times. They actually looked at 720,351 different SNPs in my genome. So they took all of my DNA, they threw out all of the data, or they didn't even collect the data, that are those parts of the chromosome that are identical pretty much no matter which human you look at, what race, what ethnicity. They're only looking at these ones that differ between races, between ethnic groups. It happens that this mutation is one that most genetic companies look at, partly because of what I told you previously, that this mutation is associated with where you're from in the world. And so they look at, this company looked at 720,000 plus SNPs. And if you think about having 23 different chromosomes in humans, that means they're looking at about 31,000 different spots on every one of our chromosomes. It's not quite true because the chromosomes are different sizes. But the distribution of single nucleotide polymorphisms, mutations across the chromosomes is pretty much equal. In other words, looking at 23 chromosomes, these companies have genetically tested or determined my identity at about 0.02% of the entire size of my genome, which is about 3 billion nucleotides. So if you look at 720,000 or so, you've read about a tiny fraction of the genome. So you can do this too at RS182549 now. I know that I'm lactose or likely to be lactose tolerant. And if you want to download your genetic testing information, your ancestry testing information, you can start, if you know which of these mutations, which of the RSs are associated with certain human diseases, which you can find out on the internet, you can get medical information about yourself from your ancestry testing. And that raises one of the most important points about considering whether to get your ancestry testing done. Mainly, you want to think about privacy concerns. How is the company storing your information? Who do they release it to? Will they ever give it to law enforcement if law enforcement comes knocking with a warrant or something like that? Because what if an insurance company somehow got a hold of your genetic testing information and they started looking at all of the different SNPs that they know are related to different susceptibilities to human diseases? That's been a concern for a long time about genetic testing, and it's, in my opinion, personally, a bit overblown, but it is always possible that that sort of scenario could happen someday. If somebody gets your genetic information, they can find out certain things about you, and if that did happen to wind up in the hands of some nefarious actor, doesn't have to be specifically an insurance company, of course, that could cause you problems later in life. So a few things to think about in terms of genetic testing, and I hope you've learned a lot and enjoyed this video. I'll see you in the next one.